For second-time mom Katie Green, the birth of her daughter was an uncomplicated and easy delivery. But then she heard the news that baby Hannah had jaundice.
I was concerned. I was concerned because you're always concerned if the doctor comes and tells you that something's not quite perfect with your perfect new baby. But I also had heard of it before, and I knew it was pretty common.
According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, about 60% of all babies have jaundice.
Jaundice is yellow color of the skin. It's caused by the pigment bilirubin. Everybody has bilirubin in their bodies. Adults have very small amounts. Newborns typically have a slightly higher amount. So it's very common for newborns to have some yellow color to the skin. You might even notice it a little bit in the white part of the eyes being yellow.
There are several types of jaundice, but the most common one, the one Hannah had, is known as physiological jaundice and usually goes away on its own. Another type is breast milk jaundice.
One of the reasons that babies have higher levels of bilirubin is because of breastfeeding. Because with the way that breast milk is digested in the body, it causes the body to retain bilirubin.
Breastfeeding jaundice occurs when the baby is not getting enough breast milk.
Babies at first are relatively dehydrated, especially if their moms are breastfeeding. In the first 4 to 5 days, as the milk is coming in, the baby loses water weight that they're born with, so that increases the relative concentration of the bilirubin.
Sure. The most severe cases of jaundice can occur when the baby's blood type is different than the mother's.
So that's why the mom's blood type is routinely checked as she's delivering, and if she is at risk for having a difference with her baby, then the baby's blood type is checked. If there's a difference between the blood types, then the mother's antibodies get into the baby's system. They break down the baby's blood cells, which releases this pigment called bilirubin. So those are the babies that we monitor most closely. What we're really trying to prevent is very high levels of bilirubin that in the most extreme cases can lead to serious consequences, principally brain damage. It's very rare for it to happen now because we intervene much earlier than that would occur.
In mild or moderate cases, jaundice will resolve on its own within 1 to 2 weeks. But for those babies with higher levels of bilirubin, phototherapy is needed.
The main treatment when the bilirubin level reaches a level that's worrisome is ultraviolet light or phototherapy. That converts the bilirubin into a form that's more easily excreted out of the body. And the nice thing now is that the technology allows us to often do this at home. It's not necessary to keep a baby in the hospital for this treatment.
Baby Hannah and her mom Katie were able to go home from the hospital on day 3 as scheduled, but she made sure she monitored Hannah.
So as you're looking for all those wet and dirty diapers and spending a lot of time nursing her and breastfeeding her and feeding her, that you're looking for her eye contact and that she's responding to your voice and looking for some of those really early milestones is really fun and important too.
For CNN, I'm Susan Hendricks.